My grandpa told me you can have anything you want, but you can't have everything you want. So choose what you want and make that happen, and don't let something stand in the way. Get this thing going, get the place warmed up. We'll see. See, I already hate this. This already sucks. So today we're working on some custom handles for some pan lids. It's like I have a big family. It drives everyone insane. Like if you half-ass something, they're all like uncontented with mediocrity. Yeah, well, that's how you get through life, right? You know, you can't just sit down on your ass and be like, oh, well, this one's too hard. Then walk away. I'm not going to go to work today. I feel shitty. No, you got to get shit done. You got, like, stuff has to happen. And there's always a way to get something done if you put your mind to it. I guess like one of my biggest pet peeves is when people bail before you even leave their house. I don't know, man, it looks pretty chandeliered up there. That pitch is really wet. It's too warm today, you probably shouldn't pull onto that dagger. It's too cold today, you probably shouldn't pull onto that dagger. I climbed like 10 days on last week. Fuck, like I just fell in the river. I don't wanna go climbing, I'm soaked to my waist. It's always worth like getting out and seeing what's going on. Just cause it's a little wet doesn't mean it's not in.
What's Jackson's style of climbing? I think his style is just his grand statement to doing what he wants and not being held in by the confines of what people expect you to do. Jackson chooses really aesthetic routes. He picks these rare, ephemeral, crazy, wild lines that don't come in very often and are usually like thin and a little obscure.
It doesn't look too bad to the ground. It's just like when it's like ripping that hard, I always try and climb faster than I probably should. Just because you're like getting like water just running down into your armpits and stuff and into your boot, and you're just like, oh, this sucks. So the original plan, I came out 2 days ago and this root Jesus wept was in. Looked thin, but pretty good to go. Since like 2 days ago, it's warmed up substantially, and the other two roots back in the farther back up the canyon both fell down that are the same aspect as Jesus Wept. So we decided not to get on Jesus Wept for fear of it falling down on our heads. Instead we went and climbed some thing in the corner. I can't remember what it's called, but it's like super cool. Yeah, fun. Warm as shit. Everything in the canyon is sort of just delamming. I was out here like a month ago. It was pretty good conditions, but we haven't had a great season so far.
Jackson has a pretty wild tolerance for risk, and most of the time we see this and we can applaud him for that. But I also think what's important to know is that he's backed off of a lot of lines, and I think that he's developed a sense of like when enough is too much.
The motivations for climbing are, honestly, it just feels like a pursuit of adventure, the pursuit of the unknown. You don't know what gear you're gonna get on an ice climb, what the mix line's gonna look like, what the rock's gonna be like. Going down to an area where you can go be free, you can go explore. It's like just a crazy environment, and you can go and do what you wanna do. It was my buddy Matt Tuttle was climbing in the area, so I knew the ice was in out there. I figured it'd be like worth driving out. And on the drive in on the road, we just saw this massive hanging pillar. And it was like, holy shit, we have to hike out to that thing. It's the aesthetics of the thing. When you walk out there and they're standing in the back of this cave, like 25 feet out at this dagger, it's like, how do you get to the ice? That's always the question, right? Like, how do we get to the ice?
Yeah, I think this is going to be the last bolt, guys.
Hey.
I touched his eyes before anyone else in this world. Just saying. No one else touched his eyes before. Cheers. Now I just have to send the fucking thing.
Full value, dude. It was full value for sure. That was heinous up there. I want another beer and like a... Did he really? I pulled some slugs out of the wall while I was bolting. I would imagine someone was shooting at the dagger a while back. Just got done bolting a new mix line. New Choss mix line. Probably like one of the coolest daggers in Utah. That's probably like the biggest dagger in Utah, I bet, dude. That like doesn't touch. And it's gonna be cool. Gonna try it tomorrow.
And there's a really cool first pitch to it. There's these two pillars that have formed up this season. One's really thin, like a little pencil thin pillar, and the other one's like a pretty cool, like four. And then you like walk a little ways through the snow to get up into the cave and under the dagger. And that's immediately when you're just like, holy cow, like this thing's huge. The ice is massive on this thing.
Swung around it all day, like breaking my neck all day yesterday, putting bolts on it. So I'm pretty stoked to get up there and see what the holds are like. And yeah, if she's gonna go or not. It's a clip up, dude. We're going sport climbing.
Jackson had told me that he bolted a new mix line, but I assumed it was some scrappy like corner or something. I didn't know it was going to be this huge bolted cave line. That's not something Jackson does.
That's the first figure four I've ever done.
As soon as I saw the dagger, it made sense to me why he was bolting it. Jackson needed to get to that ice. He needed to climb that. That was the prize. He could care less about clipping the bolts and doing the moves.
The climbing totally put me out of my element. I can count on one hand the number of times I've heel hooked. I'm for sure new to the projecting mentality. I don't seek out bolted mixed lines though, or like seek out cave routes. It's not really my style.
Yeah, I mean, you didn't do this mixed climb to do a hard climb or say he's climbed in whatever. He did the, like that route because it was still an adventure, and that's why Jackson likes it. It's an adventure.
Let's start off in here. Jesus loves to go today. It's a little cold out for the rock climbing, but it's like 5'10" rock climbing up to it. Like it'd be scary probably to try and mix climb it. I mean, we'll go see what we can do anyways. All right, let's do it.
So I don't really go out looking for hard fucked up routes necessarily. I think it's interesting to climb them. It's like I've climbed some ice, you know, but I want to see if I can climb some of the harder ice that's got a history to it. It's like, oh, that's like a pretty neat route.
Jesus Wept is super full on, no falls for sure. Super technical mixed climbing on not good hooks up cobblestones. So it's pretty much like a solo. Then getting on really thin ice. It's funny, I haven't heard him say anything sketchy or, well, that was fucked up, but I talked to him after he did Jesus Wept, and I'm like, oh, did Ben film it? And he's like, I hope so, because I'm not doing it again. So it's like, it's probably full on, if he says that.
Originally, I thought I was going to just be able to pull my gloves off and just like rock climb up some cobbles, but once I got up into the chimney and it was like full shade, kind of cold, the breeze going, it's like, oh, there's no way. Keeping it kind of for real is kind of neat, just because it's kind of cool to be able to test yourself and test your skills, especially coming from like an aid climbing background, placing anything from the smallest offset micro stopper to pounding in bird beaks to placing like a 0.75 Camelot in like a little hole like in between cobbles just filled with sand.
No, watching Jackson climb Jesus Wept, I think you'll never understand the capacity of what's really happening. You don't understand what it's like to put a cramp on front point on the sloped edge of a cobblestone. nobody will understand how improbable those moves are. You trust that every move before the last held because you know what you're doing. So that in turn sometimes compounds, because truly you're on such a small margin of error that yes, your skill got you to where you are, but you don't know when you cross the line.
There were some nerves holding onto the ice. It's a hard transition going from the rock to the ice. Pulling onto the ice was pretty memorable. The gear in the last three quarters of the rock route was like not great. And so even though it was thin, when I pulled onto the ice, once I had my feet up on the smear, it's just like, this is over. I can climb ice.
In this season, he did Shores of Pluto, Solo Matriarch, Jesus Wept, and a lot of other very impressive climbs that some people, if they did one of those for their whole climbing career, they'd be psyched. And like, he did a lot of them this season. Every previous season, he's probably done shit just as impressive. If you weren't filming him or with him, like, majority of the people wouldn't know all the stuff that he did this season.
So projecting doesn't necessarily appeal to me as much because it's hard to dedicate, like with this line, I've dedicated, you know, five trips out to this zone so far, which is, you know, an hour and a half drive each way. So it's hard to dedicate that time, you know, a day off work, you know, bailing out of work, being irresponsible for a day and money that I need for trips this summer. The dagger fell down. And it's slightly reformed now with two little individual smaller daggers, so you have to climb higher up on the rock. So we bolted it so we could pull onto the curtain pretty early. So now we might just have to gun it to the top a little bit higher to pull onto one of those daggers. It's just spooky because it's only probably like, what, 18 inches around. Feels like good ice today, good temps out, but it could just fracture really easy and you'd go for a mega ride. So I don't usually get all that nervous before some of like the scarier routes that I've done. But like on this one, I had some pretty wild stress dreams the night before going out there to climb it. The whole pitch was a waterfall and like I had to wait a whole year to come back and climb it. And then another dream that it had been done on gear like 10 years before. Like there's a bunch of people out there like hanging out like, oh, actually we did this like 10 years ago and we did it on gear. Yeah, retro bolting is definitely scarier than falling off like an X-rated route, I guess.
pretty full-on belay up there. I'm pretty into this sort of thing, and that, yeah, it's kind of a balance of trying to figure out how much slack to pay out to give a soft catch so he doesn't swing back in, but then topping it out is kind of doing the math. It's like pretty close to hitting the ground if you blew it on the top out, so. First couple swings seemed like they were good, and then there's one up high that sounded a bit off, like, oh shit, maybe it's all gonna come down. But yeah, I'd say I probably gave it a 50-50 odds of the dagger coming down.
We have Choss. We have potential for figure four and figure nines. We have Paul Bunyan sized moves. We have edges thinner than a peso. Ice that's thinner than the edges. So what does this all add up to? Probably M45.32489 water ice 13X plus.